Castro scores twice as Kaizer Chiefs see off Elgeco to gain advantage. Kaizer Chiefs made a confident stride towards the next stage of the CAF Confederation Cup, and won for a second game since Ernst Middendorp took over as coach, as they beat Malagasy side Elgeco Plus 3-0 in the first leg of their second round tie at the Moses Mabhida Stadium in Durban on Saturday. Philani Zulu hammered home the opener with a superb finish in the 33rd minute at the end of a smart build-up as Chiefs impressed with a new style passing game, and Leonardo Castro got two goals near the end. The Colombian forward's 86th minute goal came as much relief, and then a penalty in stoppage time could well prove vital over the two legs and was as much as Chiefs deserved. But it could have been a much more decisive victory had they not rushed matters on a slippery surface in the near-deserted Durban venue. Chiefs passed the ball around crisply and with pace, but made too many errors at decisive moments, betraying a lack of vision or decisive decision-making. Kamabiliot was the chief culprit, also too often caught offside, but for the errors he remained dangerous with his pace and unpredictability. Castro, too, continued to look bereft of confidence in his finishing after scoring just twice the season, but to his credit worked hard for the team. Chiefs also had to contend with some horror tackling and a rather poor hand on the game from young Botswana referee Tyrlo Moitswain. The Malagasy side were well organized, even though largely outplayed, and it will be no easy task for AMACO C when they head to Antananarivo for the return game next Saturday, chasing a place in the third round early next year. The second half saw Elgeco playing a little higher and therefore making it tougher for Chiefs to attack, but there were still chances for Biliot, Castro, Zulu, and Libogang Manyama to score. There was some stout defending to keep Chiefs at bay, and it looked tenuous for Chiefs until the 86th minute when Biliot and Castro combined to get the second goal. Then substitute Dumizani Zuma was brought down a minute into stoppage time, and Castro stuck away the third goal. "We have a good base going into the next game. We deserved this result," said the new coach after the final whistle. "We have a week now to prepare before we go off to Madagascar, and I'm quite confident we'll make it to the next round." Middendorp said after Wednesday's win over SuperSport United he did not believe in making too many changes to his side, even if up against underrated opposition in continental club competition, and was true to his word with three changes, two of them enforced.